two South Africans also in.
Great to see the camaraderie between the swimmers as the backstroke flags get put into place.
Because we have the semi-final of the men's 200 individual medley. Chase Kalis, the champion in the 400 individual medley here in Tokyo, swimming in the semi, the first of these two semis in the 200 individual medley. They're chasing Ryan Lochte's world record, a colossal 154.00. Jérémy Desplanches is the fastest into this, but leading them out into this first semi-final. Seto Daiya, world champion from Japan.
Andrei Zilkin from the Russian Olympic Committee is in lane number one, 26 years of age, has the Russian record.
In seven from Norway, Tomoya Fass, 21 years of age, stepping forward onto the biggest stage of his swimming career so far.
Well, I'd like to see him make it through to the final. Here is László Cseh from Hungary. He's been around for such a long time. What a great performer.
And six for Italy is Alberto Razzetti. Again for Razzetti. Can he step forward from the semi-finals into the final?
Having already won a gold medal here at Tokyo 2020 in the 4x200 freestyle relay, second in the 200 freestyle, now the British record holder Duncan Scott in the 200 IM.
Five, United States of America.
Here's one of the favourites then, Chase Kalis. World bronze medalist in this event, but he's the Olympic champion in the 400 individual medley, coming down to the 200.
And lane four of this first semi-final is Jérémy Desplanches, representing Switzerland. He's the national record holder. He raced 100 breaststroke here, finished just into the heats, 28th ranked. He has raced 200 IM before at the Olympic Games, finishing 13th in 2016.
Duncan Scott's British record at 155.9. László Cseh, the 35-year-old. Everybody around world swimming would like to see László Cseh making it through to the final, giving hope to everyone in their late 20s and 30s. It's just a number, folks. Cheh with 6 Olympic gold medals, 13 world championship medals and 23 European medals, 14 of which are gold. The first semi-final in the men's 200 individual medley.
Off to a start in the first semi-final of the men's 200 metres individual medley. The butterfly is up first, and already it's the Hungarian legend László Cseh that takes it out in the first 50 metres. You see him across there in lane number two without the cap, and probably trying to go out with him as well is Duncan Scott. Let's see who gets on the wall. And it is Cseh at 24.74, so he's giving it something.
He's doing what he can, László Cseh. Great turns around the wall, and we know he's got 4 terrific strokes. So Cseh just in the lead now. Also closer to us, Vass from Norway in lane 7. Chase Kalis not really involved in the conversation at the moment, but we know there's more to come in the second half of the event from Chase Kalis. Duncan Scott in 4th for Great Britain.
It's a great backstroke leg by Cseh, 29.10, the fastest of the field. Now into the breaststroke, and this is the moving lap for those that fancy themselves as a 100 breaststroker as well. And coming through is Chase Kalis. Also, the Brits coming through, and the Swiss, Desplanches.
Now, Desplanches is a breaststroke specialist, and it's no surprise to see him working his way up through the field. Can László Cseh hang on? He's now dropped to third position as they turn with 50 metres to go.
Seto over in lane number eight, trying to steal the show, trying to get into the final at a home Olympic Games.
Finally, Seto is hitting some form because he's just half a body length in the field, but they're fast finishing. Watch the freestyle specialist of Duncan Scott cutting through the field now. Silver in the individual 200. Scott takes the touch at 156.9. Seto with a very popular second place finish. And third for Jérémy Desplanches. Where is László Cseh? 157.6, tiring on the final 50 freestyle. He'd done all the work up 150, but the field came past him in the closing stages.
We'll keep an eye on whether or not Cheh can make it through. He has finished fourth with a time of 157.64, so that might be the cutoff. We'll have a look at the next semi-final. Duncan Scott really showing perfect timing for the finish of that 200 IM. Cheh across on the left-hand side of screen without the cap, led for almost the first 150 metres. And then that freestyle was just perfectly timed. A great last 50 metres, and Seto sets himself up into making the final.
As we see Duncan Scott and Seto, the two in form from the first of these two semi-finals. But where was Chase Kalis?
158.0.
Behind the pack at the midpoint after the backstroke, working hard to bring himself into up with the leaders, but just fading. 158, he'll be disappointed with that, and that's not going to be good enough to make it through. Keep your eyes on the 157.64 fourth place from László Cseh as we take a look at the lineup for the second semi-final in the men's 200 individual medley here in Tokyo 2020. And a chance perhaps for Michael Andrew to step forward in international competition at the highest level.
Sates, Matthew Sates from South Africa. He's only 18 years of age, making a big step up into the senior ranks at the Olympic Games.
Philipp Heinz from Germany, the 30-year-old, is swimming in one. Sixth place in Rio, fourth at the World Championships.
The Spanish record holder is in lane number seven, Hugo Gonzalez. Finished sixth in the 100 metres backstroke here at the Games. Also raced in the 2016 Olympic Games.
In two for Australia, this is Mitch Larkin. Seventh here at the 100 back. He's an Olympic silver medalist in the 200 back, so watch him in the second quarter of this 200 medley.
Wang Shun is in lane number six, representing China. He's the Chinese national record holder. He's won a bronze medal at the Olympic Games. 156.1 personal best.
In three, it's Hagino Kosuke for Japan. Silver medalist in Rio 5 years ago. Can he win another medal here?
Lewis Clareburt has had a great competition at these Olympic Games. He made the final of the 400 IM, finished in seventh, just faded. But hopefully he can put in a good time here and make it through to another Olympic final.
And the fastest qualifier into this, Michael Andrew, the 22-year-old American. He's going to go on the charge for 150 metres. The question is, can he hang on in the closing 50? From the heats, he was fading very badly as they came to the final 25. Stroke shortening up. I wonder whether he's going to pace it a little better. What kind of condition is he going to bring to the final 50 in this 200 individual medley?
Faded with a 30-second 50 freestyle at the end. He'll be quick. He'll race the 50 freestyle at these Olympic Games as well. Mitch Larkin sacrificed the 200 backstroke for this, the 200 IM. Will the gamble pay off?
swimmers are called to their marks for the second semi-final from the Olympic 200 individual medley. Watch for the American Michael Andrew striking out at the beginning. He's also going strongly from six is Wang from China.
Great first 25 metres to Michael Andrew. Doesn't have a strong second part of that butterfly kick, just lets the legs float. It's working for him though, stays nice and flat. At the turn, 24.00, yet again, he's under world record pace, so he is swimming in exactly the same way so far as what he did in the heats.
The only way he knows how to go, it's all arms on the fly, now bringing in a little bit of work on the legs, and Michael Andrew is trying to break the rest of the field. Wang is going with him and also going well, the backstroke specialist for Mitch Larkin of Australia. They're the top three as we come into the midpoint of this 200 medley.
Well, Wang, the bronze medalist from 2016, has closed that gap just a little bit, 0.49 behind Andrew, 53.65 at the 100 metre mark, 29 second 50 metres backstroke. Mitch Larkin is trying to force himself in there, but his better stroke, backstroke, has already been swum.
Michael Andrew swam in the final, the individual final of the 100 breaststroke here in Tokyo 2020, pulling away from the field as he always does. He's going to be miles in front of 150. What have the field got in response on the final 50? And what has Michael Andrew got left in the final 50 now? Because he's beginning to hurt, but still under world record pace.
Popped straight up. There wasn't any hanging around underwater. 11 100ths under the world record pace. How does he look with 25 to go? Has he got anything left? He's so short again.
Desperately trying to hang on. Wang will sense that Andrew is vulnerable, coming in like a train, but there's two in front of the rest of the field at this. Michael Andrew finishing, fading with every stroke as Wang takes it. 156.22 in front of the American Michael Andrew, second in a 157.0. The rest of the field tightening up around them, eating into the lead of Michael Andrew, but the American holds on for a second place. And Wang and Andrew will go forward easily into the final. Hagino for Japan with a 157.4, leading, well, the third place as we have a host of 157s in the second semi-final.
We see some of the highlights. You just wonder whether it's the right way to swim this 200 IM if you keep coming up with the same result. It's a definition of insanity, isn't it? It is Wang. By the time the breaststroke came through, Andrew was still a mile in front. Here he is on the turn. John, I think he's gone 31.6 in the 50 freestyle on the way home.
It's a huge breaststroke that Michael Andrew brings to this 200 individual medley, but the technique somehow on his freestyle just doesn't look as comfortable as he does on the other strokes, which is a surprise, because he's a terrific sprinter on the 50 freestyle.
Wang comes home in a 27 high, and Andrew goes 31.68. Wow.
It's a horrible split, but he's still in the conversation. Look at this, 157.0. The rest of the field haven't been able to beat him on that, and that includes Hagino, it includes Clareburt, it includes Larkin, Gonzalez from a new Spanish group that are moving forwards at Tokyo 2020. This is what it means. Wang leads the way in front of Duncan Scott, Seto, and then Michael Andrew. And I feel as though Wang and Scott will feel as though they're the favourites now for the medals. They've got the measure of Seto. They know Andrew is going to fade in the closing stages. And, well, it's an emotional time for some of these athletes at the end of a 200 individual medley.